Okay, dear ladies and gentlemen, our distinguished guests and everybody who joined us this lovely afternoon to celebrate this remarkable moment in the history of the AIFC Academy of Law. My name is Jan Kachev, I'm with the AIFC Academy of Law and your moderator for today. This afternoon we are hosting graduation ceremony for our students who, despite everything that was thrown against them, successfully finished their foundation's program. What makes this graduation special is the fact that it is hosted online. All frontier educational institutions and platforms around the globe understand that the studying process must continue. And we at the AIFC Academy of Law share and value the pioneer practices. We do believe that our students need to obtain and get education no matter what happens around the globe. Today, we have a few activities prepared for you to make this day memorable, including speeches by our honorable guests and the director of the AIFC Academy of Law, presentation of the certificates, and student speeches on the learning outcomes of their program. Despite the fact that the event is hosted online, we're still aiming to make it, you know, as social as possible and interactive with a hint of your help. It would be amazing if you can turn on your web cameras and keep them live during the ceremony so we could see your faces, emotions. This would make this event almost as good as if it was live. At the same time, we would like to ask you to turn off your microphones and, you know, to avoid causing unintentional disturbance during the ceremony. You never know what happens outside the window. It could be a car honking or something which will disturb the ceremony. So please, if you can do this, do it right now. Thank you. And now, with no further delay, I am delighted and honored to invite Professor Igor Rogov, member of the AIFC Academic Council of the AIFC Academy of Law, for the speech. Igor Ivanovich, vam slovo.
Добрый день, уважаемые коллеги, уважаемые студенты, уважаемые гости. Я рад приветствовать от имени Академии права МФЦА собравшихся по случаю знаменательного явления, каковым является церемония награждения студентов, работавших по программе «Основ права МФЦА». Благодарю вас за то, что вы сегодня здесь вместе с нами. Сегодня присутствует много молодых людей, которые решили изучить неведомую ранее для них отрасль права. И я думаю, что они не ошиблись в своем выборе. Правовой режим МФЦА специально адаптирован и разработан для ведения бизнеса в соответствии с международными стандартами. Акты МФЦА приняты на английском языке специально для удобства ведения бизнеса в МФЦА, положение которых уже знакомы игрокам мирового рынка. Акты МФЦА были одобрены правовым консультативным советом Международного финансового центра, членами которого являются высококвалифицированные юристы, представляющие известные лондонские юридические фирмы и адвокатские палаты. Основные преимущества права МФЦА – это его гибкость в регулировании коммерческих вопросов в соответствии с современным мировым юридическим трендом и применимость в регулировании специфических вопросов. А право МФЦА может применяться и использоваться не только участниками центра, вот это особо важно, но также по выбору сторон, которые не связаны с МФЦА. Так, в прошлом году право МФЦА было определено в качестве применимого права более чем по 600 контрактам. В апреле текущего года суд МФЦА вынес решение по первому рассмотренному им коммерческому спору. Таким образом, юрисдикция МФЦА – это продукт, ну, без привлечения, можно сказать, мирового качества, готовый к использованию и активно ведущий свою деятельность. Я бы хотел, чтобы наши молодые коллеги глубже осознали то конкурентное преимущество, которое они получили в результате обучения в Академии права МФЦА. Дело не только в том, что вы теперь владеете основами права МФЦА и можете оказывать юридические консультации своим руководителям, бизнес, клиентам и так далее по правам МФЦА. Но обучение в нашей академии оно дает еще, ну, как бы это можно выразить, отсроченный такой эффект. Потому что, изучая право МФЦА, вы более или не более в какой-то степени, я думаю, в существенной степени, коснулись изучения такого серьезного юридического момента, как английское право. Ведь именно на английском праве, на праве Англии и Уэльса основаны все нормативные правовые акты, принимаемые Международным финансовым центром. А это значит, что вы, в отличие от подавляющего большинства выпускников юридических вузов нашей страны, наверное, Евразийского экономического союза, я думаю, и в значительной мере многих вузов континентальной Европы, имеете более глубокие, более такие обширные знания уже и по английскому праву. То есть это как бы задел для будущего и стимул для вас продолжать изучение этого нового для нас, я имею в виду казахстанских юристов, да и, наверное, всего Евразийского экономического союза, нового юридического института. Мы полагаем, что ваше обучение в Академии права МФЦА и использование ваших знаний на практике обеспечит эффективную работу бизнеса в юрисдикции МФЦА и функционирование МФЦА в целом. И я рад сообщить, что вы являетесь первыми специалистами в праве Международного финансового центра Астана. Мы надеемся, что ваше обучение в рамках данной программы позволит вам получить все необходимые знания для понимания правовой системы МФЦА и работы в юрисдикции нашего центра. Я желаю всем студентам удачи в дальнейших начинаниях. Спасибо за внимание.
Спасибо вам, Игорь Иванович. Thank you, Professor, for such an inspiring speech indeed. It is always delightful to see the knowledge and wisdom shared with new generations so they could use it and enhance the world among us. You know, such words, they always pursue us to do a bit more than we could have potentially done. Now, I would like to announce the beginning of the graduation ceremony. All students will be awarded with a certificate of completion of the course. And now please all welcome David Gallo, Director of the AIFC Academy of Law, who will masterfully manage the awarding ceremony and provide his own speech on this topic. David, we're all yours.
Thank you, Jan. Welcome to all of our honored graduates. We are thrilled and excited and enthusiastically look forward to awarding you with the certificates that you have earned based on your hard work and your achievements. I'm David Gallo. I'm the director of the AIFC Academy of Law. And you are among the first graduates in a new program that we just recently launched, an AIFC Foundations Program, especially designed for students. You should be very proud of what you accomplished. This is a meaningful certificate program that you put a lot of hard work into. And during some unprecedented, unusual times that we have found ourselves in, where everything is webinar based and our highest priority is staying safe, well, you managed to make time, put the effort and enthusiasm and excitement into the learning experience. You know, these moments, these graduation ceremonies, these are things you should really be proud of, and you should reflect about their significance, because these are milestones in life. You know, life is filled with not so positive events, but life is filled with many, many events that are unforgettable and make things meaningful. And graduations are one of those great moments. So you should take the time, reflect on what you've accomplished, congratulate one another, be proud of yourselves, and really feel that you've had the opportunity to deliver something extra special to bring meaning to your life. So we have about 30 students who graduated, who are going to receive their certificates today. And what's really interesting is we have a diverse range of universities and backgrounds that you come from. So local Kazakhstan universities that are represented by you include Nazarbayev University, Eurasian National University, KazGUU University, KIMEP University, Al-Farabi Kazakh National University, and Astana University. And several of you represent your foreign universities from foreign geographies, including the University of Edinburgh, King's College London, Tongji University. So here at the Academy of Law, we are really focused on preparing lawyers for international commercial law practice. And we have really tried to identify ways that we could supplement your traditional legal educations with knowledge and practice skills that are somewhat unique. As you all know, the AIFC is a common law jurisdiction, English language, that coexists side by side and constructively with the Kazakh national legal system. The two supplement each other. And when you think about legal education, wherever you went to law school, I went to a US law school, we each have our own academic backgrounds, but pretty much every law school has one thing in common, and that is that that curriculum prepares you to be a licensed legal practitioner in that jurisdiction where you got your education. Well, that's great, and that's a commendable goal. And we are all very proud of what we've accomplished. But if you think about the historical perspective on legal education, many law school curricula, so the programs, were really designed in a world that that wasn't as global as it is today. And every one of your law schools is progressive and are adapting to those changes in the legal industry. However, when we have new jurisdictions, common law and civil law, there are international legal principles, there are issues of comparative law, conflict of laws that come up in a transactional environment like this one. Well, at the Academy of Law, we look for ways to identify those maybe gaps. We look for ways to bridge some of those gaps and to truly attempt to prepare you for international commercial law practice. We try to do that by providing local legal education, in this case, webinar-based, that has global value. So, congratulations. When you think about the significance of a certificate like this, the entire academic world is changing. It's moving a bit more away from traditional so-called book knowledge and into more certificate programs, skills-based programs, things that supplement your traditional academic background. So learning is a lifelong journey, and we wish you all the very best as you continue it. And we're very proud and pleased to support this aspect of your journey that we're celebrating today. So with that, I'd like to go ahead and announce each and every one of your names individually. You'll need to forgive my pronunciations, but it's certainly emotional and heartfelt that we support everything that you have accomplished, and we applaud what you've done, and we certainly look forward to the things that you will accomplish in the future. Okay, first we'd like to recognize Abilda Barjan. Nishanbek Mansour, Nupisav Nirjol, Uspikov Kwanish, Ruslan Yuzmetahov, Boshanov Atakan, Boshanov Adakan, Borabe Gaziza, Ishkakova Asal, Mudakumar Aralim, Bachanova Akbayan, Nupasova Mariet. Jiseeva Asel. Bergman Beth Aliyah. Kudabayeva Aidana. Salabikova Yukrishan. Toktasanova Elvira. Yubilitsky Ayalam. Tugenbayev Kalal. Asabayev Sanjar. Ashimova Juldis. Omarali Aliaskar. Sargantagova Lazat. Moldabikov Yurkanat. Aitipatova Kizhibek. Mohammed Kalitske Atyane. Abdullah Arelim. Smagilov Isakan. Jandilov Barshan. Sargiskayeva Akshan. Bateyeva Anel. And that's it. So let's now together give ourselves and each other a big round of applause. Congratulations, everybody. Please join me with a big round of applause for yourselves. Thank you very much. I didn't hear much applause from our modest recipients of the certificates. Last word I'll make on this before turning it back over to Jan. Look at an event like this, whether it's a formal degree, postgraduate degree, a doctorate, certificates, awards. Each one of these events is an invitation to you. It's a call to greatness. So with your academic education, you can now shape your destiny through your hard work, your creativity, and choosing to be part of something big, choosing to make a difference. So this is your call to greatness. We wish you the very best. And now I turn it over to Jan.
Thank you, David. I do believe that, you know, the sole reason why we didn't get much applause because our students, they do know that they've worked hard and achieved amazing, outstanding results, but maybe a bit too shy to acknowledge this. I think, you know, all the time they will definitely appreciate this, maybe not with an applause, but one day they will realize that this was definitely special. Sincere thanks to you, David, for such an insightful and inspiring speech, outstanding ceremony it is. What amazes us most that we all gathered here from different cities and universities, which are both local and international, but here, you know, we're still celebrating the achievement of our common goal. We at the AIFC Academy of Law believe that education defines the future, and the Academy of Law team joins David and congratulates you on your graduation. We do thank you for participating in our program and for your dedication of time and knowledge. And we do believe that you've gained a lot through this program. So our next item on the agenda is to provide an opportunity to the students who completed the course and would like to share their opinion on the learning outcomes and the values they obtained during the foundations program. You know, it's taken you a lot of time and dedication. And apart from getting a knowledge, you definitely got some sort of a personal experience, which you would like to share with us. And for this purpose, we are inviting Borjan Janadilov to provide his student speech. Borjan, we're all ears.
Thank you for giving me the floor. Well, first of all, I'd like to express my gratitude to the legal team of the Academy of Law, not only for launching this amazing program, but for transferring it into an online platform, giving us an opportunity to continue learning about the key main principles of the AIFC law. So thank you Thank you so much for that. Indeed, it was a great pleasure to be a student of the Academy of Law and to be enrolled in the AIFC Foundations Program for Students. This program allowed me to learn more about the foundational aspects of the AIFC law and to understand how the legal system works at the AIFC. Being a master's student of China University of Political Science and Law, I'm writing a thesis on international commercial courts and arbitration, and I found the model on the dispute resolution very insightful and valuable. It gave me a clear image on the operation of dispute resolution at the AIFC and a chance to clarify some questions that I had regarding AIFC Court International Arbitration Center. Moreover, I would like to highlight other models that the program covers, such as international exchange, AFSA, and Islamic finance, which I found a bit challenging for me, but at the same time triggered my interest in further research. This program won't be so attractive and interesting without the great impact of high qualified lecturers. Thank you very much for your contribution and being open to the students and their questions. I hope that AIFC Academy of Law will continue launching other programs that would be more than that I would like to be more to attend. Thank you.
Thank you, Borjan. We do appreciate the words of our students and grateful for such a speech. It is amazing to hear that being a person of law, a student of law and politics, you also found time, you know, to do additional research, to find something or exchange on the Islamic finance. This is probably, you know, the main goal of our programs, not just to give you knowledge, but to spark this interest in you to find more about the AIFC and to enhance your knowledge, to broaden your views. That's, you know, thank you for such a speech. And now we would like to invite Anel Bataeva to share her experience with us. I do believe that Anel do have something to tell about her personal experience, what she found the most interesting about this program. Were there any challenges or maybe some things that she enjoyed most? So Anel, the floor is yours.
Yeah, thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Anel Bataeva, and I'm a graduate of the Foundations Program conducted by the AIFC Academy of Law. First of all, I would like to say that it's a great honor for me to deliver a speech on graduation day, and would like to congratulate all of the members with the successful completion of the program and acquisition of the certificates. I remember the first day when I met everyone at the interview for getting into the program, and to see that we've come to an end of the journey that lasted nearly 3 months makes me sad and yet proud of everyone. So having a function of an educational platform, the AIFC Academy of Law helped us, its students, to gain profound knowledge in the AIFC legal system and common law methods. I think it's outstanding how the program brought together people with various backgrounds and from different disciplines. For instance, me being an economic student, never had an experience to learn the principles of the AIFC law and how it's independent from that of the Republic of Kazakhstan, and to get to know about AIFC court, arbitration, mediation regulations. So hence this once again emphasizes the fact that the program is arranged in a way so that no matter which educational area one comes from, the student with the eagerness and passion to learn and dive into the legal matters of the AIFC and generally world jurisdiction will be able to succeed. And all of this certainly wouldn't have happened without the educational lectures kindly provided by the AIFC experts, employees and executives who shared with us their time and experience to really give the best information to students. And Mr. Ablaihan Obakir, who was always there to provide us with the reading materials, videos, and always ready to help us with our questions, which allowed the participants to smoothly go through the learning process. So from all the students that participated in this program, I would like to express my sincere gratitude to David Russell Gallo, each and all of the specialists, organizers, and members of the AIFC Academy of Law for arranging the program, which gave a unique opportunity, like really unique opportunity to obtain awareness of the AIFC structure, its bodies, participants, and legal acts that, as mentioned before, are based on the principles of the law of England and Wales and the standards of leading global financial centers, which shows that the graduates of the program can later use all of this knowledge. And like not only within the borders of Kazakhstan, but also in the international area. So in a way, thanks to the program, for some of us, it might be the beginning of the legal career path, while for others, it may be the continuation of pursuing a path of working in a sphere related to the AIFC jurisdiction or other global financial centers, applying the foundational knowledge of legal concept that we've got during the course of the program and further improve it to grow into competent specialists. On this note, I will end my speech and wish everyone luck in their further studies and to stay safe and sound, especially during these tough times. Thank you.
Thank you, Anel, for such kind words. They do mean a lot of us. Such students as you are, they do outline that knowledge is for everyone. It doesn't really matter whether or not you are a lawyer, economist, or a person who is somehow related to, you know, governmental management, etc. Knowledge is still just a knowledge, and expanding your and broadening your outlook, that means everything, because as soon as you stop studying, that means that you stop developing. And in such a competitive world nowadays, you do have to be flexible, agile, and gather more and more knowledge to be not just a better professional, but also a better person. So thank you, both of you, for such a lovely speech. We do appreciate this. We do believe that many of you have something to tell about the program, your experience, but unfortunately, you know, the time is limited. So we do thank Anel and Borjan for providing such a lovely speech. Now, you know, we would like to move to our next list on the agenda. And here in Kazakhstan, the part of our culture is to listen to people who are wiser than us and whose words are invaluable. Their experience is only outmatched by their regalia and the marks of distinction from the state and different respected bodies. It is my privilege, honor, and to invite Professor Bahajan Abdrahim for the speech. Professor, we're all attention.
Thank you very much. Yeah. Salamatsizlarmi, hurmatli bugungi церемонияға қатысып отқан студенттер, жастар, біздің әріптестеріміз. Ең біріншіден баршаңызды мына бүгінгі қасиетті бүкіл мұсылман қауымының мейрамымен құттықтауға рұқсат етіңіздер. Қасиетті ораза айты болып жатыр. Сол себептен баршаңызға денсаулық тілеймін, үлкен табыс тілеймін. Мынау биылғы Рамазан айы сіздердің естеріңізде ерекше қалатына сөзсіз, себебі сіздер осы Рамазан айын дұрыстап пайдаланып, осы екі айдың арасында үлкен білім, жаңа мүмкіндік пайда болды сіздерге. Сол себептен осы мейраммен тағы да сіздерді құттықтауға рұқсат етіңіздер. Друзья, я хочу пользуясь случаем поздравить вас всех с праздником Ораза Айт, который празднуется во всем мусульманском мире, пожелать вам всем здоровья, добра, успехов и сегодняшняя церемония награждения, она носит особый характер. Вы в течение двух месяцев прошли полный курс Foundation, вы ознакомились с основами право МФЦ, вы поняли, каким образом функционирует арбитражный суд МФЦ, судебная система как работает, как на каких принципах строится медиация в МФЦ. Это все для вас новые возможности, которые позволят вам адекватно, профессионально и компетентно реагировать на новые вызовы. Вы сегодня, если можно сказать образно, находитесь у подножия большой горы. И те знания, которые вы получили в течение двух месяцев, это знания, которые, развивая которые, вы будете подниматься все выше и выше по этой горе, и вам будут открываться новые профессиональные горизонты. Дело в том, что сегодняшняя правовая наука, правовая юридическая практика, она очень многогранна. И одной из важных граней юридической практики и науки является знание английского права, права Англии и Уэльса. Поэтому это важный аспект для современного юриста, поскольку оно наиболее адекватно отражает и регулирует правовые отношения, возникающие среди участников рынка. Поэтому знание этого инструментария даст вам колоссальную возможность для того, чтобы вы могли быть востребованы на рынке юридических услуг. И МФЦА, Международный финансовый центр Астана, в частности, Академия права специально запустила этот проект для того, чтобы большее число наших молодых людей, студентов, юристов, практикующих юристов, выпускников наших вузов, зарубежных вузов, как и вы, многие из вас являются, могли быть востребованы не только на площадке МФЦА в качестве будущем и работников, в качестве консультантов, сотрудников 45 юридических фирм, которые аккредитованы в МФЦА, но вы могли бы эти знания дальше развивать для того, чтобы популяризировать право МФЦА. Оно сегодня становится важным и востребованным, потому что оно наиболее адекватно реагирует на вызовы времени. Поэтому те знания, которые вы получили, базовые знания, знания функционирования, основных принципов функционирования МФЦА, исламского банкинга, как я уже сказал, деятельности суда, арбитража, медиации, это даст возможность вам дальше и глубже развивать свои навыки. И в этом, конечно, большую роль сделала Академия права с Давидом Галло, который имеет большой опыт в этой сфере, является признанным специалистом, который уже тот опыт, который он имеет сегодня, эффективно и компетентно внедряет уже в Казахстане на площадке МФЦА. И те практикующие специалисты, которые вам читали лекции, делились своими знаниями, своими опытами, это тоже сотрудники МФЦА. И в будущем, я думаю, что многие из вас могут претендовать на позиции специалистов, на позиции менеджеров, которые будут работать в структуре Международного финансового центра Астана. Поэтому я еще раз хочу поздравить и команду Академии права с успешным завершением обучающего курса. Хочу поздравить вас, дорогие выпускники, пожелать вам успехов и хочу настроить вас не останавливаться на достигнутом, искать, проявлять больше настойчивости, больше целеустремленности, больше напряжение в достижении новых вершин в овладевании новыми навыками юридической профессии. Еще раз вам большое спасибо, друзья, еще раз вас поздравляю с успешным окончанием наших курсов и команду Академии права. Thank you very much, colleagues.
Thank you, Professor, for such an outstanding speech. I do believe that it will give each of us, no matter whether we are the employees of the AIFC Academy of Law or the students, it would give each of us something to think about, to evaluate, and to move further with this amazing and additional information. And now, you know, after such an intense and amazing ceremony, we're officially announcing the end of the event. We are grateful to our honorable speakers for joining us. We thank all our students who are here with us today. This wouldn't happen without you. We at the AIFC Academy of Law wish you all the best and hope that our path would cross many times more. As Professor Bahajan said, you do know a professional who knows AIFC law, who knows the basics, who knows what it is need to be known to be part of the team. So we do believe that our paths will cross many times more and we will achieve together outstanding results. Thank you, everybody, and goodbye.
Thank you, everyone. Your certificates will be available in hard copy just as soon as things open up. So we will be in touch with you to arrange that handover. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.